In this lecture, we will discuss about factory method design pattern. Factory method pattern uses subclass to create object of a derived class of another class which is not known. Okay, let's see the intent of factory method pattern. Define an interface for creating an object, but let subclasses decide which class to instantiate. Factory method lets a class defer instantiation to subclasses. So we have three things. Define an interface for creating an object, but let subclasses decide which class to instantiate. Factory method lets a class defer instantiation to subclasses. Okay, let's have a thought process for problem and how we will come up with the solution. Okay, we would like to develop a framework of IDE, and developers will use the framework to provide the development environment according to their organization need. For example, project which has a special part, language specific to a domain, changes in building project or debugging, etc. So framework will have project, file, build, etc. to have development environment features. Okay, let's stick to project only. We will require project creator for creating the project. But this project creator does not know which project it has to create. Rust project, Golang project, MATLAB project, or tomorrow it may be some other language or maybe system specific projects like IBM, Embedded, RTOS, etc. Okay, let's stick to Golang project and MATLAB project only. We can have Golang project creator for creating Golang project and MATLAB project creator for creating MATLAB project. Good, but again, how project creator will create project? Okay, we will have Golang project and MATLAB project as subclasses of project. Similarly, we will have Golang project creator and MATLAB project creator as subclasses of project creator. Golang project creator subclass will have a method to create Golang project, and MATLAB project creator will have a method to create MATLAB project. We can call this method a factory method. But project creator in framework should have this method to be called. So we will have factory method interface in project creator and factory method implementation in subclasses. Another method in project creator will call factory method for creating the project in scenarios like new project or save as project. Golang project creator will create and return Golang project. And MATLAB project creator will create and return MATLAB project. So we will have project and project creator in framework, as it will require generic or abstract level interaction. The specific things will be deferred to subclasses. So Golang project, MATLAB project, Golang project creator, and MATLAB project creator will be provided by developer. I have created a UML diagram for this. The classes Golang project and MATLAB project are derived from abstract class project. Suppose the project creator class wants to create a new project which is object of Golang project. It has abstract method create project which is implemented in derived class Golang project creator. New project method calls create project method. So create project method of class Golang project creator instantiates the object of class Golang project and returns it to new project. So we can see the subclass has instantiated the object of a class which was known later only. We have parallel class hierarchy here. This can be very useful in lot of scenarios. Good, you have gone through a thought process and have come up with a design solution for a problem. Okay. Let's see the structure of factory method design pattern. It will give you good understanding of participant classes, relationship between classes, and how all of them work together. Okay, let's see the participant classes. We have abstract class product. The concrete class concrete product is derived from product. We have abstract class creator. It has abstract method factory method. We have concrete class concrete creator. It has implementation of factory method. Okay, let's see how they will work together. So creator wants to create the object of concrete product, but it does not have the information of this class. So an operation method of class creator calls the factory method, which is abstract method and implemented in subclass concrete creator. So this instantiates the object of concrete product and returns the instantiated object to creator. So we can see it provides a lot of flexibility for framework, plugins, parallel hierarchies, and is used heavily in a lot of scenarios. Okay, let's see some modifications and variations applied here. We can have some variations like creator can have a default implementation. Factory method can have input parameters, and based on that it can create objects. Also, there may be some language specific variations. Generally, template method will have factory method. Here an operation is template method. So where it can be applicable? Obviously in framework scenario, which we discussed earlier, or in libraries too. A class which does not know the object it has to instantiate, or it wants the objects to be created by its subclasses. Also, there may be cases of parallel class hierarchies where it can be useful.